Welcome to the second part of this chapter, Force and Laws of Motion from class 9. This is chapter 9. So let's start. We have already studied about the first law of motion, about inertia we have studied, about force we have studied. Okay, today we are going to start about the momentum. So momentum, we have to know what is momentum, then we can go slowly to the second law of the motion. So what is momentum actually? Momentum is denoted by always with small p. Okay, so product of mass and velocity of an object is called the momentum. So what momentum is? The product of mass and velocity of the object is called the momentum. It is also called the power of the moving object. How much power a moving object can move, that is known as the momentum. It is denoted by small p, and p is equal to m into v. Means momentum of an object is defined as a product of mass and its velocity. Okay, and its SI unit is kg meter per second, because kg is denoted of mass m and v is velocity, so meter per second. So next slide. Momentum increases with increase of either mass or velocity of an object, because small p is equal to m into v. If mass and velocity will increase, obviously momentum will increase, isn't it? So if vehicle running with high speed have greater momentum as compared to vehicle running with slower speed. So if we have to compare two vehicle, like you compare a vehicle of one is car, another is cycle, bicycle. So what will happen? In vehicle, the first vehicle will go running with a very high speed, okay, with great momentum, because mass is more and velocity is more. And compared to one cycle, what will happen there? Mass is less there of the cycle in comparison to the car, and velocity will be also less, so momentum will be less there. Small object moving with great velocity have high momentum. Okay, now here given one example. Mass is given 1000 kg and velocity is given 50 meter per second, then obviously momentum will be m into v, 5000 kg meter per second. Okay, so this is the idea of momentum. In the second law of motion, we'll get the derivation of the, how you have to formulate the second law of motion, we'll get here. So second law of motion is what actually? It states that the rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to the force applied in the direction of force. So force should have here one direction, uniform direction. It will show one, that means in which side it is going. Okay, it will show one direction. So this second law of motion will state what? How much the rate of change of velocity will be there of momentum. Means time must be there of rate of change of velocity, rate of change of the momentum. If momentum, we have the v is there, no, velocity is there. If velocity is there, we have to change in momentum. If it is say, then we have to take v and u also. Means initial and final velocity will be also there, and it is directly proportional to the force applied. How much force will be applied there? So that is the second law of the motion. So we'll go here how to derive the second law of motion. See here, an object of mass m, okay, mass is taken m, any object you just think in your mind, is moving along a straight line with an initial velocity small u and final velocity v in time t. Means rate of change is given, so time t is given by the application of constant force. This derivation is very much important, students. Okay, so f, constant force is given, f means one, just constant force will be there. So here initial momentum will be what? P1. It is given as P1 is equal to mu, and final momentum P2, it is given as mv, because final velocity, so v is final velocity, u is initial velocity. So here it is taken initial momentum mu and final momentum mv. Now rate of change of momentum, that is directly proportional to f. Now what is rate of change of momentum? P2 minus P1, because final velocity, we have to see what final velocity is in mv. So mv minus mu divided by t. Again, f is proportional to m is taken common, v minus u by t. V minus u by t means what? A, acceleration. So that is proportional to ma. Now proportionality sign, we have to change it. we have to remove it. So we'll put a constant there, k, and we will put k is equal to 1. So f is equal to ma. Now why k is equal to 1 is taken here, only why k is taken as a constant of proportionality. Okay, let's understand this also. If here, let you think, mass is taken of 1 kg of an object, acceleration is 1 meter per second square, and force is also given 1 newton. Now you have to find the constant k. So if there f is equal to k ma, we know this already, we have got this formula. Then f, put the value 1 newton, k is kept there, m 1, a 1. So again we got k is equal to 1. So for that reason, k is taken as a constant of the proportionality. Okay, so till here this is second law of the motion, and this mathematical formulation you have to do in your copy. You have to note down in your copy because this is very much important for you all. Okay, so next slide we are going to talk about the third law of the motion. What is actually the third law of the motion? We will talk here, but before that we will see some examples. We'll see some examples here. So that examples will be what? That examples will be the ever talking about the here. Can you see one bowler is there? Okay, one bowler is there and he is catching the ball in such a position that the ball is taken on the back side. Okay, he has catched the ball and slowly his hand is moving on the what? On the back side. It is just moving. Because why, you know? Because this is often happened while catching a very fast moving cricket ball in a match. This is very, very much common there. Okay, so we will see that fielder will increase. Okay, in doing so, what will happen? The fielder will increase the time during which the high velocity of moving ball decreases to zero. So when it will decrease to zero only, he can catch. So he will pull down his hand on the backside. Here the acceleration of the ball is decreased and therefore the impact of catching the ball, fast moving ball, will also be reduced. And if the ball is suddenly stopped on the very high velocity, what will happen, you know? Then within a very high velocity it will decrease to zero in a very short interval of time. But while catching that very fast ball on the in up position only, the fielder may get hurt in his wrist or palm. Okay, so that is the reason the fielder always pulls his hand gradually with the moving ball while holding a catch. Okay, so till here, this is the second law of the motion we have already studied. So now we'll go to the third law of motion, but sorry, not here. We'll go to the next part of this chapter. Be patient, study today the second law of the motion. Next video, the third part of this chapter will be the third law of motion. This is very easy for you all. Okay, so next we are going to the third law of motion or the next part of this chapter. Thank you till then. Take care.